swimming across the Pacific, it's not really something that I needed to do. It's something that I wanted to do, something that I had in mind for a long time. For me, it kind of brings some type of calm and very close to the environment.
When long-distance swimmer Ben Lecomte left Hawaii in June this year, his goal was simple: swim the Pacific while drawing attention to the problem of plastic pollution.
What is very unique and different here is, in addition to bringing valid and important samples and data, we take people below the surface. It's not just about scratching the surface, it's also below the surface.
The research expedition would take Ben and his crew directly through the Great Pacific Garbage Patch.
The patch is located between Oregon and Hawaii. It's the region in the world's ocean that has the highest concentration of plastic. It's not an island. It's basically a soup where you find very high concentration of floating plastic.
Created by a swirling vortex of ocean currents, the plastic patch is estimated to be roughly 1.6 million square kilometers. That's about three times the size of France. Ben spent between 3 to 8 hours in the water every day.
The advantage we had with the swim is Ben and the crew, they were navigating and swimming at a very slow pace. So we had this fantastic opportunity of sampling at very high resolution.
I'm going to show you how we do science on this boat. It's not an easy lab to work with.
Daily sampling was done using a net tow that would skim the water for microplastics. The crew would then meticulously count what they caught.
Overnight, we crossed some invisible border that we couldn't see below the surface. And all of a sudden, we have a net tow of 700 pieces of microplastic. So much plastic, it's hard to wrap your head around.
For me, it's a very powerful way of using science, because plastic pollution is a huge issue. But if we don't know about it, if we don't see what is out there, it's really hard to get this message out to the public.
After 80 days at sea and swimming 338 nautical miles, the Golden Gate Bridge provided the perfect backdrop for Ben's arrival in San Francisco.
Now that I did it, it's even crazier than I expected.
Celebrating their return to dry land and the completion of one of the longest field studies of ocean microplastics, Ben and his crew acknowledged there was still much more work to be done.
One, two, three, Pacific Swim!
I hope that, you know, people will get inspired and realize that it's a responsibility that each one of us has to carry, and we have the power to make a decision in our daily life to change a little bit. So we don't have to be perfect about it, but we have to start to do something.